Loktantrashala ya the School for Democracy ke piche ye soch tha ki Mr. Sankaran aur kai sare dost yahan pe jo baithe hain sabhi log sabhi ke sath yahi hota hai ki jab hum loktantra ke bare mein gaon mein ya shahar mein ya professionally highly qualified logon ke beech mein bhi jate hain to dekhte hain ki democratic institutions ke bare mein jankari nahi hai democratic processes ke bare mein jankari nahi hai और एक एक जो हमें राइट्स के लिए हम लड़ते हैं मगर राइट्स के लिए लड़ने का तरीका पता नहीं है कहाँ से क्या होगा वो मालूम नहीं है तो इट इज वॉज दिस थॉट दैट ड्रोव अस टू सेट अप द स्कूल फॉर डेमोक्रेसी इन 2003 एंड इट वाज सेट अप इन अ स्मॉल पीस ऑफ लैंड अबाउट 5 acres विच इज अबाउट 2 acres इन द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ भीलवाड़ा इन राजस्थान And the first president of the School for Democracy was Jordres. And this organization took upon itself the task of opening its doors for eclectic learning. Anyone who wants to learn anything about democracy, from an unlettered peasant or worker to a very highly specialized person who has missed out on democratic wars. So this organization has been there. Many of you have contributed in money, in kind. You've been there, you've contributed knowledge. So this is a organization that's in a sense dedicated to the dream of Mr. Sankaran, in a sense.
A public servant who is thinking past and present, probably there's no one I admire more highly than Mr. Sankaran.
I had read about him even before I met him, in a very strange kind of a way. We had the cases pending in the Supreme Court for many years, PILs, which were simply sent off to the NHRC. So they couldn't send the case alone, so they had to find a lawyer to send along with it, and I was found for that. So I was the amicus curiae in the cases involving mental health institutions. I was the amicus curiae in the Agra Pratituhum case. All these got sent from the Supreme Court to the NHRC, saying these are all involving human rights issues, so they should now be dealt with by the NHRC. And one case was the bonded labor case, which had been pending since 1985. So in this NHRC, again, I had to sit to analyze all those huge reams of paper. So in the bonded labor case, came across Mr. Sankaran's work on identifying bonded labor, which was fascinating. No other bureaucrat had done this in any other state.
Having worked with Mr. Sankaran and known him for many years, I don't know how much he would have himself liked the idea of a memorial lecture after him. But the fact that we are having it, and Bezwada Wilson is the one who's the first to deliver this lecture, I think would have made him enormously happy. He would have been really thrilled, if I can say so, to have Bezwada Wilson to do this. Many of us here know who Bezwada Wilson is, but I think many do not. So I think it would be worth recounting who he is. As you can see, he is very young. He was born in Collab, where his parents worked in the KGF and were employed by the KGF as Safai Karmacharis, and they were actually doing the work of carrying human excreta on the heads. So he was born in that family, and I think innately, instinctively, he rebelled against that. And he was sure of one thing, that he would not do this and not allow others to do this as well.
As we born and we lived and we experiencing a society which is an unequal society, where the great means, it is a kind of a very, symbolizes the dominance, nothing else. So when we think about this and the Sankaran, it is two different actually. For us, anybody to speak about him, the difficulty is what we see in the contemporary world and what we have seen with him, it is a totally different. So comparing both is the difficulty. It is not talking is the difficult, speaking about him is the difficult, comparing is a very difficult. It is in a total different world when you are there with the Sankaran sir. And for me, he was always is a Sankaran sir. And I always call also sir, sir, sir. and we had a good time actually. I'm not thinking of bringing that because it is a very emotional thing, which if I bring, then I cannot even narrate the what happened, what all those things. But I want to critically and objectively see a person as an Indian citizen, just as a citizen, who attained a kind of a Indian administrative service, that is another way. But even without that also, a person from the Tamil Nadu, and just like that, from the railway department, the parents were the father, and from there exactly he has come to many places and worked in many places, given different experiences and given a kind of a outlook of each and everything, whatever he has seen is the totally different. That is what I want to just make a very clear.